Okay, in this video we are going to show that a vector field is conservative, and then after we show that we're going to try to find a potential function. So first thing we got to do is know how to figure out if a vector field is conservative. So there's like the mixed partial derivatives test. I prefer to find the curl, so what I'm going to do is to show it's conservative, I'm going to calculate the curl, and if the curl is zero then it's conservative. There's actually a couple of caveats to that, but they almost never apply except for that one example that's in every textbook. So we're going to calculate the curl. The curl is a cross product. So the first row is I, J, and K. I'm spacing it out like crazy because the components of this vector field are pretty large. So to make this look like it's spaced correctly, I got to do that. The second row is all the partial derivatives. So it's partial X, partial Y, and then partial Z. And then the third row, this thing is our vector field, so component by component. So the x component is this, the y component is this, and the z component is this. So that's why I had to space it out a ton. All right, so now we're gonna calculate this thing. So this is gonna be equal to, so we're gonna look at just the I component. So we cross out the top row and the first column. We need a 2 by 2 determinant, which means I need to find the derivative with respect to y of this thing, which is just x, minus the derivative with respect to z of this thing, which is just x, which is good because I actually need the curl to be zero. So if I had gotten anything else here, I would have automatically known not conservative and could kind of move on. So it's gonna be minus, people forget this part, so it's minus the quantity. I'm crossing out the top row and the middle column. So I need the derivative with respect to x of this thing, which is just y, and then minus the derivative with respect to z of this thing. There's no z in the first term, and then yz, the derivative with respect to z is just y. And that's good because that means that I got zero there also for my j component. And then plus k, so it's plus, crossing out the top row and the right-hand column, derivative with respect to x of this thing. No x, oh no, there is an x, that's unfortunate. All right, so the derivative of xz is z, the derivative of negative e to the x sine of y is negative e to the x sine of y. So it's gonna be z minus e to the x sine of y. So not a big deal. And then minus the derivative with respect to y of this term. Derivative of cosine of y is negative sine of y, and the derivative of yz is just going to be z. So I get the quantity negative e to the x sine of y plus z. And that also, when we simplify it, is going to give us zero, which is good. So overall, the curl for this thing is 0i, 0j, and then 0k when you look at it. That one's the most challenging, but you just simplify that. So we got a curl of 0, which means we're definitely dealing with a conservative vector field. If it's conservative, we can find a potential function. So let's do that. So for the potential function, first thing you want to do is look at the vector field and realize that we're now saying it's a gradient vector field. So the first component there should be partial x, partial y, and partial z. So the way that I'm gonna do this is I'm gonna look at partial x and integrate it with respect to x. Partial y, integrate with respect to y. Partial z, integrate with respect to z. And it's those like kind of constants of integration that really make this work out. So we're gonna integrate this with respect to x, which is not that bad. So e to the x cosine of y. So cosine of y is just a constant, and the antiderivative of e to the x is e to the x. So I get e to the x cosine y, plus y times z is a constant, and there's no x, so it just becomes xyz. So e to the x cosine of y plus xyz. And then here's the thing. If there had been any function of just y, of just z, or of y and z, the derivative of that with respect to x would have been zero. So we have to throw in a constant, but our constant is gonna be some function of y and z. And now we're gonna move on to partial y, do the same basic thing, except with respect to y. So we look at this. This should be the derivative with respect to y. So xz is a constant, so I'm going to get xyz. The antiderivative of negative sine of y is positive cosine of y. So I get plus cosine of y e to the x, or plus e to the x cosine of y. And then if there had been a function of just x, just z, or x and z, its derivative would have been 0. So I need to add another kind of generic constant function type thing, which I'll call g2, which is just a function of either x or z or x and z. We don't really know until we're done. And now we move on to partial z. So we want to integrate this thing with respect to z. Okay, so the integral of xy is going to be xyz. The integral of z is going to be 1/2 z squared. And then we're going to add in, if there had been a function of just x, just y, or x and y, its derivative would have been 0. And actually, if you look at it, so we're saying for g sub 3, if there had been a function of x or y or x and y, but if you look at what we got for our first two things, e to the x times cosine of y is that function. So we already found something like that. So let's look and see. So we want to write f of x, y, z. Okay, so there's an x, y, z that showed up everywhere. So we count everything once. So everything that showed up has to be counted once. You don't want to double count it. X, y, z showed up everywhere. We count it. E to the x cosine of y showed up in the first two. It's okay it didn't show up in the third because it's just a function of x and y. So its derivative would have been 0 when we took the derivative with respect to z. So we definitely count this. So we have this. Then we look and see, is there anything we didn't count yet? So we didn't count 1/2 z squared. And if you think about it, 1/2 z squared is just a function of z, which means when we took the derivative with respect to x, it would have gone away. So that's actually g1. When we took the derivative with respect to y, it would have gone away. So that's also g2. So we want to count that, count it once, and it's actually the function we were looking for here and here as well. So we're going to count it. And then, of course, there could just be like a plus k, so I'm going to put, you could put plus c, but there's usually c involved in these problems anyway, so I'm going to say plus k. In principle, you usually do something called the fundamental theorem on these things, and so that plus k doesn't really matter, but technically it could be there. All right, so we found the curl was 0, that meant the vector field was conservative. Once we knew that, we tried to find a potential function, and we did. We integrated with respect to x, then y, then z, then a lot of comparing, and we got it. So I hope this was helpful, and good luck.